down to 500 feet. What are you going to do?
Well, there's nothing left to do. Stand by for crash landing.
But the big bomber, no less than crew, did not crash into the Pacific. Instead, just a few minutes later, the same officer who briefed the crew remarked,
"Well, it's too bad you lost control of the plane, Joe.
I know it did. You see, you forgot one important point. I knocked out the number two engine.
You told your plane captain to cut off the gas one, all right. You didn't tell him to switch the instrument vacuum pump to the number one.
Oh.
Got enough?
Yes, sir. I won't make that mistake again."
That is how Joe and thousands of other Navy airmen like him can make fatal mistakes and live. For Joe and his crew were not really flying over the Pacific. They were sitting in a cabin on the ground, exactly duplicating the airplane they will later fly on real bombing missions, while their instructor was reproducing all kinds of flight conditions. This marvelous device was created by the Special Devices Division of the Navy's Bureau of Aeronautics, headed by Captain Louis DeClark. This coming Sunday, the National Aeronautics... It will be presented by Vice President Henry A. Wallace, and with it, a citation reading,
"For his contribution to the safe and rapid training of combat pilots and crew."
Captain DeForest is now at the Marshall Times Washington microphone. Come in, Washington. Go ahead, Captain DeForest.
No one learns anything without making mistakes. Air combat is no exception. But there, mistakes are fatal. If you make a mistake in combat, you may not live to correct. In naval aviation training, students are taught their fighting jobs in synthetic training devices, where they have a chance to experience the conditions of battle before they are exposed to its hazard. They can be given the dress rehearsal and have the opportunity to make mistakes where they cross the line. Our flying and fighting equipment is the most powerful and effective the world has ever known. But make no mistake, this product of American genius and industry is no child's play to operate. Yet this complex equipment is of necessity entrusted to the average youngster barely out of high school, to the kid next door whose folks hesitated and let him drive the family automobile. We are thankful that synthetic training is doing its share in giving our Navy pilots and air crew the thorough, realistic training they need to destroy a dangerous and competent enemy. And what is close to all our hearts, we are thankful that it helps them to come back. Thank you.